everyone. I'm Lenn Woolston. I am a writer, blogger, and nerd, and today I am becoming also a reader and sharing with you exactly all that are my fall favorite reads. I've been doing a lot more reading than I have previously through means of audiobooks and ebooks and actual physical copies and everything, buying some, using my library, and I have just been really reading a lot more than I've had the opportunity to do previously, and so I wanted to share with you kind of my top fall favorite reads that I have been reading with you, so that if you definitely are checking out something or wanting something that is in that fall theme and everything, I've got you covered. The first is the Cassidy Blake series that is by Victoria Schwab. And I will just be upfront and say that City of Ghosts is the first installment of this series. And this one I didn't read this fall, but the sequel came out, the anticipated sequel, Tunnel of Bones, came out. And so I read this and I loved both of them. And to just kind of give you a background as to what the series is about, it's about a girl named Cassidy Blake who has this exceptional ability to see ghosts. In fact, her best friend Jacob is a ghost. But her parents are also kind of like paranormal investigators, if you will. And so when they get the opportunity to go film a show being all things paranormal, they end up in the first book, they end up in Scotland. And so there, Cassidy realizes that she has this gift not only to see ghosts, but to help them. And so that's what she does. And so in the sequel, they actually continue with their journey, but they now are in Paris, specifically the catacombs. And so I will go ahead and read you the blurb. Trouble is haunting Cassidy Blake, even more than usual. She, plus her ghost friend Jacob, is in Paris where Cass's parents are filming their show about the world's most haunted cities. Sure, it's fun eating croissants and seeing the Eiffel Tower, but there's true ghostly danger lurking beneath Paris in the creepy underground catacombs. When Cass awakens a frighteningly strong spirit, she must rely on her still developing skills as a ghost hunter and turn to her friends, both old and new, to help her unravel a mystery. But time is running out and the spirit is only growing stronger. And if Cass fails, the force she's unleashed could haunt the city forever. I really enjoyed both of these. I mean, they're done by Victoria Schwab, so I mean, seal of approval right there. And I actually had the opportunity this fall to meet Victoria Schwab in person for the Tunnel of Bones launch party, and I just, oh man, she was amazing. But yeah, so she was able to sign these and everything. And I would say that if you are looking for something that involves ghosts and you also really are a fan of V.E. Schwab's writing, definitely check out this series. The second book I got was an ebook that I borrowed from my library, and it is called The 100 Lies of Lizzie Lovett by Chelsea Sadotti. And I would definitely say to check this one out if you are looking for a little bit of mystery, but also really like young adult contemporary, because this is a story for you. And here's the blurb. Hawthorne wasn't trying to insert herself into a missing persons investigation. Or maybe she was. But that's only because Lizzie Lovett's disappearance is the one fascinating mystery their sleepy town has ever had. Bad things don't happen to popular girls like Lizzie Lovett, and Hawthorne is convinced she'll turn up at any moment, which means the time for speculation is now. So Hawthorne comes up with her own theory of Lizzie's disappearance, a theory way too absurd to take seriously at first. The more Hawthorne talks, the more she believes. And what better way to collect evidence than to immerse herself in Lizzie's life? Like getting a job at the diner where Lizzie worked and hanging out with Lizzie's boyfriend. After all, it's not as if he killed her, or did he? I really enjoyed this book because not only is it kind of a unique way of whodunit, it also kind of really makes the main character Hawthorne explore who she is and kind of dive into why she is obsessed with this girl named Lizzie Lovett. And so it's definitely more on a contemporary side than it is on like a mystery or like horror side or anything like that. But it, to me, is a great fall read because again, there's that mystery aspect of it And her theory about what happened to Lizzie is very fitting for Halloween time, I'll say that. And lastly, the third and final of my fall favorites is The Missing Season by Gillian French. Guys, I loved this book. Like, I was pleasantly surprised by this book. I picked this up because it was recommended to me on Goodreads, and I really, really liked this book. So it's perfect for Halloween time. It's a young adult story. I would say it's kind of mystery, but it also, also on the side of horror, kind of, because there is a creature involved in everything. And so I would say that it's more of like a young adult thriller, like the mashup of those two, but it is so good. And here is the blurb. There's something in the marshes outside the town of Pender. Whenever another kid goes missing in October, the town's adults are quick to offer excuses. Overdose. Train accident. But the Pender kids know what is really behind it. A horrific monster they have named the Mumbler. That's what Clara's new crew tells her when she moves to town. Bree and Sage, who take her under their wing, Spirited Trace, who has taken the lead on this year's Halloween prank war, and Magnetic Kincaid, whose devil-may-care attitude and air of mystery are impossible for Clara to resist, no matter how hard she tries. Clara doesn't actually believe in the Mumbler, not the way Kincaid does, but as Halloween gets closer and tensions build on the town, it's hard to shake the feeling that there really is something dark and dangerous in Pender lurking in the shadows waiting to bring the stories to life. So, of course, this one is perfect for Halloween time, fall time, and everything, but the writing was just so superb, and the characters were just so relatable, authentic, and it really brought me back to younger days and everything, and so highly recommend this. I will kind of go out there and say that this is probably one of my favorite reads of 2019. So there you have it. Those are my favorite fall reads of this season. And I really want to know, what have you been reading? What are your recommendations? Put them down in the comment section down below, because I would love to check out what you guys are excited about when it comes to books. Give me all the books. With that, I just want to say thanks for checking out my channel. Go ahead and hit that like button if you liked this video and like to hear more about what I'm reading. Also, don't forget to subscribe on your way out so you never miss one of my videos. With that, have a wonderful weekend, an amazing week, and I will see you guys in the next video. So until the next video, bye!